Good morning, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. A woman is dead after colliding with a fire truck yesterday in Deering. The fire crew was heading back to the fire station after battling a brush fire yesterday afternoon. Just a half a mile up the street there, police say a Honda SUV crossed the center line on Route 149 and crashed head-on into the fire truck shortly before 6 o'clock. 62-year-old Carrie Ainsworth of Deering was rushed to the hospital, but she died from her injuries. State police investigators spent hours reconstructing the scene and say the driver of the fire truck did everything he could.
The Honda, which was heading north, was in the southbound lane. Fire truck saw that, attempted to avoid it by going into the opposite lane, and then the collision occurred right there in the center of the road.
Both firefighters in the truck were also taken to the hospital to be checked out. Police say their injuries were not serious. It is still not clear why Ainsworth crossed the center line. Officials say she does have a brother who also lives there in Deering. A driver faces drug charges after crashing into a telephone pole in Pelham. Police say 21-year-old Zachary Randlett of Dracut, Massachusetts, fell asleep at the wheel on March Road Sunday morning. When officers arrived, they say Randlett tried to throw out a duffel bag full of marijuana. He is now charged with drug possession and intent to distribute. A large fight in Manchester last night ended with two people in the hospital. Police say a fight involving several people broke out around 6:45 in the area of Beach and Manchester streets. It's not clear what the fight was about, but one man was stabbed in the leg. Another was taken to the hospital with a head injury. Both are expected to recover. So far, no arrests have been made. The New Hampshire Army National Guard is celebrating a major milestone. For the first time in a decade, not a single member is away on deployment. The last member was welcomed home from Kosovo on Wednesday. There are 1,700 members of the New Hampshire Army National Guard. At one point in 2010 and 2011, 1,000 of them were deployed.
It kind of signals that we are stepping down operations in U.S. Central Command and in Afghanistan and Iraq, which is good news for our families and our employers.
The Major General says having everyone home was a great Mother's Day present. 12 members of the Guard are scheduled to head to Afghanistan in September, and there are still 153 Air National Guard members on deployment. That's it for your morning webcast. We'll have an update at 1 o'clock this afternoon. Have a great day, everybody.